course, the third go-round for Diaz against Pacquiao. Jim Bradley's trainer, brother of former lightweight champion Julio Diaz, and the contender Antonio Diaz, and trainer Lucas Matisse, 35-year-old Argentinian champion.
So Matisse's trying to control the distance from the outside, which is smart. You have to do that trying to catch Manny Pacquiao as he comes in.
Got to be willing to throw when he does that.
Yes.
You will get those shots out of round number two. Roger with us here. Coverage coming from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia, here on ESPN Plus. Glad you found us here on ESPN Plus. And want to remind you that this is the place to be if you are a boxing fan. We got the big events left and right. Remember, pound for pound elite, Bud Crawford fought, beat Jeff Horn here on ESPN Plus. Got another fight for a title coming up on July 28th. And the classic fight archive is beyond anything you'd ever want to see, from Top Rank and beyond. ESPN Plus, a fight fan's dream, just $4.99 for the total package of all sports. And glad you're with us to join Manny and Pacquiao's return here. So used to seeing the calm approach, the steady guidance of Freddie Roach, no longer with Pacquiao. Hugo Fernandez, the chief second.
They have not spoken since Australia. I'm kind of shocked to think that Pacquiao didn't even reach out to Freddie Roach when his mother Barbara passed away around Christmas.
Sunday morning in Malaysia. A long time since Kuala Lumpur has hosted a fight of this magnitude. You have to go back to when Muhammad Ali was 33. Gets to Matisse. Let's see what Pac-Man has.
Still has those punches from odd angles.
Here he comes.
Ooh, 45 type uppercut came right up the middle. Split the guard of Matisse.
And now we have an answer to one of the central questions here, which is, how much power does he have left?
Remember, no knockouts for Manny Pacquiao since November of 2009 against Miguel Cotto.
Pacquiao still got to be cautious because Matisse has that punching power. He doesn't want to walk into anything.
Like what he did against Mark Davis back in the day after they traded knockdowns.
Pacquiao being smart on his attack, using his jab, trying to move forward. Trying to find an opportunity for Matisse to sit still for just a second to explode the combinations.
Last time Matisse was down was 3 years ago against Victor Postata.
TKO in the 10th round. His chance at a 140-pound belt then. Pacquiao trying to pin him in that corner. As Matisse will settle back in here.
Those punches come from wide angles. They come around, they come underneath. It's hard to gauge him. You see that? He moves in. Punches from every angle. And they're fast and hard.
Feels like a sharper Manny Pacquiao than what we saw down in Australia against Horn.
He's sharper because he's fighting against a smaller guy who can't lean on him, dirty up, and bully him in the same way. The physical dimensions are different. And probably to Tim's point, I think it's human nature for Pacquiao to have underestimated Horn.
Yeah. But the longer layoff here, maybe some fresher legs for Pacquiao. And more purposeful training camp. Compared to what you just described.
They're 39-year-old legs either way.
True. They need to be freshened up. So the knockdown scored in round number three. As Diaz will get to work with his charge, Lucas Matisse.
Hey!
I'm telling you. metal boss.
Y van a poder. Esa izquierda la está metiendo dos open y recta. Saladito.
Saladito. Saladito. Saladito.
Saladito. You call this a 45 or maybe you get a...
Ay, ay, vamos a la cara.
Right at the guard of Batiste. Oh, the guard. The punch that you don't see will hurt you.
There's an awkwardness to Manny Pacquiao's running his whole career that is so effective. That was an example of it.
Look, 45, not very serving,
is what he's always been. And it got the best of Batiste there in round number three.
And it was lightning fast.
Total power punches, 31-16 connect advantage for Pacquiao. The left uppercut, the best of them all.
One of the reasons that punch is possible, Batiste leans in.
Yes, he does. You lean over the front foot. That's what happens. Get that stuff with uppercut. Pacquiao will look for that shot again.
Nearly caught him with a right hook that time. Yep, setting your head up like it's T-ball and giving your opponent the chance to hit a home run.
I told you, no head movement from Batiste. He doesn't move his head.
Diaz was asking for it after that last round. He was getting into Batiste saying, I need more head movement.
About to see the same pattern as the last round from Batiste.
He's trying to get around the guard now with that left hand is Pacman. A hold from the jab of Batiste. Pacquiao comes in behind the double jab. Batiste goes to the belt line.
So accustomed to seeing naturally bigger guys. Batiste is basically a 140 pounder. If I'm not mistaken, the last real 140 pounder that Pacquiao fought was Ricky Hatton.
And you know what happened on that night?
Yes, we do.
One of the most sensational finishes you'll see.
Beautiful right hand right there from Batiste.
That's the shot he wants.
Every now and then, Pacquiao step back with his hands down. Batiste stepped in with the right hand. He clipped him right there. A good shot by Pacquiao coming back with his straight left. Getting off the line. Getting that head off the line. They throwing that left hand. He's famous for that.
Off the hip and lunging with it.
Round of your third fight with Pacquiao, you boxed marvelously. You kept that right hand by your head the whole time. The second you dropped it, he got you. It seems to me that for Pacquiao, the same type of thing applies, that Matisse's best shot is if he drops his left hand.
Yeah, he drops his left hand, but the problem I made was I double jabbed, and he came right down the pipe with his left hand. I didn't see it coming. Look at the speed and power of Manny Pacquiao here. Good right hand from Batiste. As Manny trying to move in, came in that mid-distance range, he threw a straight right hand. And here you're gonna see Pacquiao laying his straight left hand there. Getting off the line and landing that straight left hand. And here Pacquiao. Stocking. There's the famous left hand where he steps off the line and he throws the straight left hand down the middle.
Sir, suntok. Matama ba? Hindi pa.
Nakita pala yung bunga mo.
Wala na, papay na. Inalis yung pangalan.
You know, tapi ni. Mesti doa landscape, para ano? Hindi pa ni landscape pa pwede ganyan.
Notice fight's not over, but I'm impressed with the speed of Manny Pacquiao and the power of Manny Pacquiao. Still, 39 years old.
No.
Backs him up, utilizing that jab, comes from left hand, and gets around the guard. And Matisse, kind of a cover up for a moment here, so Compubox Town, he says Pacquiao out in front, consistently outworking him in the first four rounds.
Matisse still doing the same thing, looking for his opportunity to land that big punch on back. Trying to be patient, trying to pay.
Well, he knows what his weaponry is and what he's capable of. No matter what you see, no matter how consistent the work early by Pacquiao has been, including, by the way, a sensational uppercut for Scorpio Pacquiao, Matisse is never going to be out of this thing because of what he possesses with that right hand.
Well, that's the price of patience here, is that he has to endure a beating on the way to get that shot, toward the opportunity to get that shot.
That's the only way he can get this fight, I believe.
That price of patience also comes with rounds being scored against you. Not just the pain that you're taking. There's a left hand to the body from Pacquiao, and then comes with the left hand that gets around that right guard.
To this point, I think this is Pacquiao's most physically dominant round.
I want to see a little bit more body work from Pac. He goes out to that body. See, Pac stepping inside right there, trying to recharge. Allowing Matisse to go ahead and hit him.
That's what Jeff Warren was doing to Pacquiao.
There's a clash of heads there.
Now you see Pacquiao doing it to Matisse.
Once again, Matisse leaning forward with his head and creating the opportunity for Pacquiao to land that left uppercut.
And creating the opportunity for a headbutt. Nice left hook right there from Matisse.
Solid work with that left hand. There's a body shot from Pacquiao. Matisse gets off his best combination following it.
Pacquiao started getting a little relaxed in there. Matisse is still dangerous.
Then a counterweight.
Having some moments in this round.
He takes a knee after Pacquiao lands. Second knockdown of the night score by Pacquiao. What a turn. Pacquiao's getting relaxed. Matisse was finding a little bit of room. And just like that, it happens again.
Matisse discouraged the speed and the power of Manny Pacquiao. It's frustrating him. He got clipped with a little shot on the tip board. He went there and took a knee.
As I said before, that's the price of patience. While he's waiting for his shot, he's taking all his blows, and no one except for Lucas Matisse knows how much pain that's inflicted.
Here's Manny Pacquiao stocking with that jab. Comes around with a little short hook. Chris Matisse looks like he's going to tip possibly.
Hey, because he's going to get
there, right, Tim?
Hey, what did the team from Matisse, got clipped on the table. He's him taking a knee. I'm kind of confused. It wasn't a shot that hurt him. But after this frustration and getting hit over and over and over and over
again. Stop standing in front. You're right in front of Pacquiao. He wants movement. He's not getting it. Round number six. Matisse's been down twice. Below blow here is the warning from Kenny Bayless.
Below
the bell.
Huh? Below the
time. As he needs
to go.
Kung naman to, eh, sabi.
Kung naman to.
Kung naman to.
Sakit.
Sabi niya, kung naman to. Kung naman to.
Dami na ito po eh. Sino sinuntok si Manny?
Sa itlog.
Sa itlog?
Kaya, na lang ito.
Pacquiao, Matisse, a little bit of the momentum coming off of the fifth round. But obviously,
The late rebirth of Pacquiao, if it keeps up like this. Pacquiao that undoubtedly will be headlining another card if a W comes his way against another big name. And right now, all the other big names, everyone we've spoken to between 135 and 154 pounds, they all want one guy. That pays the bills. Well, maybe they'll want him a little bit less now. Everybody mentions his name.
I'm going on them right now. Don't be surprised if Matisse don't come out in one of these rounds.
Hey, listen. The power's in there. He can show it.
On Pacquiao as he won't trade in.
Needs to double that up even more. Keep going with it. There's that uppercut again from Pacquiao as he splits the guard. Left hand combination.
He
doubles up the jab. He leaves himself susceptible to the same shot. Pacquiao hit you. Yeah. Let's throw the right hand behind it. Pacquiao trying to get under that guard there. Placed the body shot moments ago. Matisse comes forward again. We're looking at a guy who's going to be 23 years. 23 years, 5 months.
Wait,
I
hindi nga nakuha yung buong screen eh. Manood din sila ate. Ate, kapatid mo. Si Ate Gail.
Depende kasi sa bansa, mawala tayo sa
malisa. Hindi, may tinuro. Wala naman ang bulit sa mga yan. Oo, sa mga ilaw.
Matisse, he looked like he's trying to go down their body with the right hand.
He was down south, really down south. When Pacquiao fights someone his size, even in his advanced year.
Right, you still got some rounds to go. This fight's not over. That's the beauty about boxing. And you got a guy, Matisse, who has the punching power to end it.
He has knocked Denzel in 5 of his 44 career fights. And of course, 36 of his 39 wins have been by knockout.
That's what I'm going to share.
1-2 from Pacquiao. Comes with the lead left hand.
Sino na ka lahat mga friend mo nakakanood sa iyo?
Full night of boxing that started in New Orleans with awesome action of the undefeated guys who are boxing stars, and then we bookend it and cap it here with a living legend Manny Pacquiao against the title holder Lucas Matisse.
It's going to be we saw the birth of Regis Prograis as a star tonight here in Portland. First thing out of his mouth, be Pacquiao. Same. I want to see that fight. There is a question as to whether or not Pacquiao can or will fight
for the
It's an excess of, as I understand it, an excess of $20 million.
Well, when you make that much against Mayweather, it's going to be a big ticket item.
Batista using a jab, but not throwing the right hand. His corner keeps asking for that right hand. It seems like he's afraid to throw it. He doesn't want to leave himself out there to be countered.
But you have to have the willingness if you want to beat the Pac-Man.
Yes, you do.
That would go toward Justin Fortune's
point. Pinapalabas ito sa atin.
Oh, yung mga nakalag.
Yung mga cable.
Cable. Same time, ganyan din. Yung mga hindi. Mas waalasin ko po matatapos.
Oh! Knockout na? Kilo lang.
Pangat daw.
Tempon. Ay, tapos na.
Tapos na, bro.
Kilo na, buti na!
Bakit kumayaw na siya?
Ay, ano, tamit. Di na kayang
kumayaw.
Uppercut niya. Tatanong, hindi ba ito channel? Ano ito, di ba? Si Chris.
ESPN Plus
daw to, no, Chris.
You're welcome.
Seven round lang dapat.
Hindi pinakita yung uling card.
Mahina to.
Pagatasan mo, be.
Balot.
Breastfeed, kailangan breastfeed para ano.
That was a big shot that left over. But he has his wits.
You can see that he
has quicks. No, he's ah, tinigil kasi dinuranan niya.
No one knows but Matisse how much those shots
really hurt. Siya kasi dinuranan niya. Right now, right there. Hirap sa ipin.
Let's get
official.
Sino?
Okay, pero marami na kasi ng internet na yun. Internet na ito.
Pag-ingin natin English yung Pacquiao.
May 2015 against Floyd Mayweather. It's just a blip on the radar now. Fourth fight since then.
Malakas din naman talaga kalaban niya kasi hindi pa naman niya kasi nakalaban niya yung
kasi.
Hindi nga
makasuntok.
Hindi, salamin na mga kabi. Kala ko nakakontak lens ka. Hindi ko kasi naantok ako eh.
Many would say it was a long and a tooth. Lucas Matisse, who happened to get himself a belt, but still a dangerous fighter with dangerous power. Manny was successful in sensational form with a seventh round TKO. Let's go up to Diane.
Your speed was unbelievable. You caught him numerously from round one and you put him down in round three. Were you surprised that it came that early? You said you were going to take your time.
We go home.
I'm surprised because he's a very tough opponent and knocked him down. So that's a bonus for
Christmas.
Being focused and
a big surprise.
Another knockdown in round five and another one in round seven to finish the fight by a KO, your first KO win since 2009. Manny, when was the last time you knocked down a fighter three times?
Oh, a long time ago. Thank God for this
wonderful opportunity.
To all the Filipino people, for the other country. Thank you to my former president.
They wanted to come out smoking, and you sure came out smoking tonight. How would you rate your performance?
I'm not smoking. We did a good job in the team. We did a good job in training. We were not pushing hard like we did before when we were young. Just we control ourselves for the training, but it's heavy training. So we did a good job, but thank you. Thanks to all my team for working hard this fight.
Manny, with this performance, who would you like to fight next?
That's another story. I'm happy to go back to my country, the Philippines, and to celebrate the victory, of course, with my fellow countrymen, of course, and doing my job as
a professor.
I
know you've got the State of the Nation address coming up.
Pero nakalaban niya na yung data.
With your work in the Senate, do you think you will come back to box? Will you fight again this year?
We're trying for that. Right now.
Sorry, advance mag-isip kasi ate.
Advance
mag-isip eh.
Yeah.
My country, relax.
What a great performance, Manny. And I'm sure you want to address your Filipino fans here all over the world and your president sitting right up there.
Oh, nandoon.
Mga Pilipino, maraming
salamat. Ito nakatingin sila lahat
dito. Dude, pre!
Filipino people,
maraming salamat. Masilag pa sila tayo. Rodrigo Luano Duterte. Masilag pa sila tayo. Rodrigo Luano Duterte. Masilag pa
Also, the Prime Minister, Mateo, thank you so much
for your support.
Manisa government, thank you so much for your support. And of course,
the whole
family, thank you.
Thank you.
The push was asked. Role as a public servant, elected official back in the Philippines. But trust me, all over the world, there are a lot of fighters who say, oh, I would like that.
Of course. Manny Pacquiao looked dominant tonight against Batiste.
Hindi na in-interview yung kalaban, no?
What was the most difficult part of fighting Manny Pacquiao?
He's a great fighter and a great champion.
I know you said you were going to catch him, hit him, and put him down. What do you think happened?
He
dijoke
lang ako nun eh.
Kasi ako nun kasi
it was turned around. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose. Today was my turn to lose, but I lost to a great fighter, a great legend, Manny Pacquiao.
Lucas, you worked hard for this. What would you like to do next?
Trabajaste muy fuerte para esto. ¿Qué te gustaría hacer ahora?
Primeramente descansar, volver a mi casa y nada.
Take a rest, take a break. I worked really hard. I want to go back home with my family. And, you know, this is part of boxing. You win some, you lose some. Today it was my turn to lose, but nothing more.
What do you want to say to your people of Argentina watching back home?
Sorry.
Sí, no, un saludo a Argentina, perdón, pero bueno, estoy bien, a mi hijita, a todo el relevo, las pibes, las mil, a toda la familia, a otra Argentina, la concha de su madre.
That I'm okay, thank you for all the love and support, and we'll be seeing all my family and friends, and thank you for all the love and support that they give me. Yeah.
All right, there's Lucas Batista now saying, I'm putting out too much for him. Todd, back to you.
Thank you, Diane. I think it's interesting in asking. Let's look at the copy box numbers, guys, because Pacquiao landed him in every single round. You look at the power punches, 44% is a high percentage landed for power punches. He landed later in round 179 and 36. The two left uppercuts, the third round, the finisher in the seventh round, and then the short right hook that put him on the temple that clearly had a big impact in the fifth round.
For Manny Pacquiao's career, and he turned that all around. It's the most difficult part of any fighter's career to negotiate the end. And now Lucas Batiste is closer to making that realization than Manny Pacquiao. The future of boxing is who does Manny Pacquiao fight, when, and where?
Would we get that answer soon enough? Timothy Bradley, I give you credit for when we were asking the impact of Freddie Roach not being there. You said, I have confidence in Bubba. I thought he looked in great shape, was fast, was sharp, was accurate, looked far better than he did last summer. Here is the welterweight division.
Oh,
Puro todo talo.
Basta yung rapper siya sa akin, Mexicano.
With all the experience he has and all the trilogies and all the things that he did in the sport of boxing. I'm not sure if that's it, but I think it was a large part of it was fighting the guy himself.
Maybe Bud Crawford is next for Pacquiao. Who knows? Welterweight division is loaded. Guys at 140